know Michael Jackson owned 50% of Sony Records? Michael Jackson owned the Beatles catalog, which made him 50% owner of Sony Records. Sony Records said, oh, no way. So Michael Jackson's album Invincible comes out. And what does Sony do?
Hey, fam. Welcome back to another video. Welcome back to another reaction. This is Segovia coming to you live from the Man Cave. Hope everyone out there is having a good start to the week. Happy Monday, y'all. We made it. But hey, we got a good reaction. I had a lot of fun putting this one together. I ain't gonna hold you guys up much. Let's get into the reaction. All right, here we go. Now, the reason I'm not holding you guys up much is because this is about my 30th try trying to get this damn intro down. I just can't do it. So you know what? No intro today. Let's just have some fun. Enjoy the reaction.
Chad, I knew he went to an Illuminati party. What happened? They were fucking each other on camera? Snow baby fucked a kid?
That was weird. Like, it's like everybody in the industry was in one room. Even the people who hated each other acting like nothing's happening. There was like these girls, but like it was like weird. It was almost like paid escorts. It's like they're dancing off beat.
Like PTA members.
All executives of the game. Like that night, I wasn't supposed to go in. It was actually, I'm sure that what place it was in LA, because I remember what place it was. But I was supposed to meet somebody in the parking lot. We ended up, I don't know how the fuck we ended up going in there. And the whole time I'm in here, I'm like,
Wait, so you're in a parking lot and you just end up in a
No. I got invited.
You got invited?
No, not to the event. To meet with this guy when he was going to be there.
Oh, and they wanted to initiate you.
I don't know.
Did you bump a little? Oh, yeah, sorry, okay.
The NASA has recorded the voice of God in outer space, and weird. The audio is at the end. Last September, scientist and Harvard professor Oliver Hurd was conducting research at a NASA space observatory. He was experimenting with different sound frequencies, aiming to convert electromagnetic waves into audio files to analyze space sounds. This technology is often used for communications in space expeditions or to anticipate events like the arrival of meteorites to Earth. During his observations, Oliver was puzzled to hear something that seemed to be a human voice. The sound was deep and slow, as if someone were saying, "Come to me, my son." At first, he thought it might be an error or an unusual coincidence, but the next day, upon hearing it again, he was convinced it was no coincidence. When he reported his findings to NASA, he was surprised to be immediately dismissed and threatened not to disclose his discovery to anyone. Despite everything, Oliver decided to share what he had heard online. He posted the audio for others to listen to. If you want to hear it, click on this icon, select more, and press voice notes, or comment audio of God.
China's new video game law is extremely terrifying, and this is why. China's new law restricting video games for minors under 18 is effective tomorrow. Online games are completely banned Monday through Thursday, and teens can play 1 hour from 8 to 9 p.m. on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. That is a total of 3 hours a week. Real name verification required to play video games, and a limit monthly spending of $57 max. Do you think this is too far?
Well, apparently on April 4th.
Yeah, they're planning to take over the world, y'all. They're planning to take this world over. That's great. Those are some crazy rules. But I was a parent, right? I would think, not looking at it as a government saying this, right? Looking at it as a parent, I don't have kids, so I don't know. But I would think I would have those type of rules on my kids, right? I don't know, though. Call me crazy.
There's a solar eclipse that's going to be happening. Multiple schools in the United States are going to shut down on this day because of the solar eclipse. So there's schools in Ohio, Kentucky, Arkansas, Maine, Indiana, Texas. Also, it's not just isolated. It's all over the United States. They're all going to shut down. So this sounds like this is a premeditated event again because it's not isolated nationwide. Why are they afraid that they think they need to send children home or they can't come to school for a solar eclipse?
Probably because they've been watching too much television.
I never heard in my entire life schools getting shut down because of a solar eclipse. But apparently all these schools all over the nation are, so.
Well, it only lasts for like a few minutes.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. It's only a few minutes. That's why I think it's stupid. They go, what school would do this? But they are. They're all saying we're shutting it down. So this seems like another premeditated event. It's almost like the news. When you hear the same thing on news channels all over the United States, somebody's telling them to say this stuff. So when you see a nationwide shutdown, somebody on the federal level is telling them something.
Flat Earth is real. Hey, the world is not round. If it was, I could disprove this many times, but anyway. There's an ice wall around our three-dimensional world called Earth that lays on two-dimensional plane. But we're trapped in the center on this planet in an ice wall. This is why, if you fly from anywhere on Earth to Australia, I know, to Antarctica, why do you always have to fly to England? To make it seem like the world is round, you had to travel that far. From Florida to Antarctica is about four and a half hours on a straight shot. So why the fuck you gotta fly from Florida to London and then there? Anywhere you come from, you gotta go to London and then, London and then, London and then there. No, you're going to London because the reptilians there said you must come through there.
I will tell you this about Tupac in the movie Above the Rim, mm-hmm. That people might not know is, so during that, he got shot the first time during that. All that stuff, the rape allegation and claim that came out and the shooting of him happened during Above the Rim, mm-hmm. right? At the end of it. So at the end, I had the director and the producer come to me and is like, okay, we're going to change up the end of this movie. He's, you know, he's been shot. So we think we're going to do this. We're not sure, but we think we're going to do this. So they had this entirely different path to take on the film. Mm-hmm. Turns out they found in the crowd a lookalike who looked just like Tupac. So
yes. Well,
they utilized the lookalike who happened to look a lot like Tupac, was the same stature at the end of the film. And that's how they resolved that.
Damn.
You ever notice when you by yourself in the store, somebody watching you? Somebody following you. When you at the park, certain people stare and just look at you. When you driving, people just stare at your car. They don't even see you. They see what's in you. Whatever's in them is wondering what they doing here. They ain't supposed to be here. Where they come from? See, you got something in you that's shining so bright, the darkness cannot stand it. So they're wondering, how can I stop them? What are they doing here? That's why you keep on driving past people that look in your car. You know what I'm saying? They be looking at you, don't speak, don't smile. Oh no, I'm like that. They follow you around Walmart, follow you outside. They want to get rid of you. They on assignment. Some of these demons have an assignment to get rid of you. Some of these demons just wandering around in the physical inside of people. They are. And everybody that has a light, they want to run them off. They want you to be scared. That's why they stare at you. They want you to see them. You can feel their energy beside you. You can feel somebody looking at you. That's for a reason. And when you look at them, they just stare at you. Get away. Pray. I'm telling you now. Because they're a demon inside flesh right now. And trust me, some of them will come get you and take you out of this world because they know you're living for God's purpose.
Now, I won't say followed around the store, outside in the parking lot, you know, but do you guys have people? I constantly, forever, as long as I can remember, every time I look up, someone's staring at me. And, you know, even like my ex-wife used to always, but to me, it was never a, you know, I've had females, like I look up and they're staring at me, but you can see in their eyes, they mean good, right? They, like you said, you feel the vibe, right? I've had so many people, family, like it's crazy, but look up and just see people staring at you, but not with good intentions, right? Not with a good heart. You know what I mean? Like I get that all the time. And I get people that have a good heart too. And, you know, will smile when you look up at them or you know, whatever, right? I've even probably got caught zoned out, not even thinking, but just staring at somebody without even realizing it, right? But I've always felt that, and I've always felt I don't want to say a negative vibe, negative energy, but a different type of energy when I look up and people are staring at me, right? Now, I've had good and bad, but more bad. So that, I put that video in there because that's happened to me a lot. Let me know down below. Does that happen to you guys every time you look up in the gym, driving? You know, you look over in your car and someone's staring at you, or let me know down below. I get that a lot.
Everybody's asking, Pat, why are you calling 2024 the year of chaos? Let me explain to you why. Because 2024 is known as the greatest election of all time, not because of America, but because 40 countries' election are happening this year, most ever. 3.2 billion, that's 41% of the world. $44.2 trillion of GDP, that's 42% of the world. Think about the chaotic place you've ever been. What causes chaos? DMV? Chaotic. Hundreds of people there, right? Concert? Chaotic. Leaving a football game? Traffic. Oh, parking lot? Chaotic. New York City? Chaotic. Las Vegas Strip, New Year's Eve? Chaotic. Airport? Chaotic. What causes chaos? A lot of people trying to get through something fast at the same time. This year, 41% of the world is trying to elect their leader. And you know what countries? U.S., we're one of them. India, you want me to go through some of them for you? Pakistan, Indonesia, Venezuela, Mexico, Sudan, Taiwan, Tunisia, Austria, Belgium, U.K., South Africa, South Korea, European parliamentary election, and more. And the people of power don't like it when there's so many moving parts because they're losing control. The people of power don't like the fact that there's a lot of losing of power economically, politically, you know, all these, including spiritually, some of these religion and churches that are running around the world. So today we're going to make some predictions. Some of them are going to come true. Some of them are not going to come true. But a few of them are going to get you saying, really? You believe that's going to happen? Yes. We believe this is going to happen.
That's crazy. 41. Now we know how crazy. I mean, look at our last election year. COVID happened. Whole world shut down, right? Not just the country, the whole world. So what's going to happen this year, right? What's going to happen this year? Because there's 41 other countries. So if we do something crazy on election year, I'm sure we're not the only ones. I'm sure every country does, right? So 41 countries, I think something crazy is going to happen this year. I don't know what it is, but I mean, the energy just feels off.
I know the script for the NFL next year. You know, we're going to the Super Bowl. What school?
I mean, the energy is so off. We got Chad Ochocinco right here predicting the Super Bowl conspiracies on national TV, y'all. That's how crazy the world is right now.
Joe Burrow go to?
LSU.
Where's the Super Bowl next year?
New Orleans.
That's it.
That's the script.
That's the script.
You got it.
I said it first.
Bengals get their first ever championship.
There we go.
Now let me ask you this. You're a receiver. You know star receivers.
Yes.
You know T. Higgins.
Yeah.
He wants to be a star somewhere.
Hey, T, I love you.
You got a message for him?
He's coming to Arizona.
T, I love you. What? Call me.
All of them. You name your biggest black actors. You name your biggest white actors. You name your biggest female Latino actresses. They all have to do it. A blood oath. Now you bend over. Now every orifice that you have is going to be annihilated. All these guys, they take your humanity from you. You know how the feminist movement has categorized men. I think that, what was his name? Samuels had the podcast that was the women hated. Kevin Samuels.
Kevin Samuels, yes.
Kevin Samuels was eliminated because they didn't want to go back to that. They want these women ignorant and twerking. They want kids running around the street. If they don't pay the income tax, they put them in the penitentiary and they get their money out of them that way.
Do you know Michael Jackson owned 50% of Sony Records? Michael Jackson owned the Beatles catalog, which made him 50% owner of Sony Records. Sony Records said, oh, no way. We can't own half of this, even if he's the number one selling artist of all time. So Michael Jackson's album, Invincible, comes out. And what does Sony do? They give him no promotion. They sabotage Invincible to make sure Michael Jackson goes into debt. And then they come back to Michael and say, you're in debt, Michael. You owe us a couple mil. Give us the Beatles music. Michael says, no, I'm going to have a concert, raise the money to pay y'all off. You're never getting the catalog. Michael Jackson made one mistake. He was living in Dubai with his brother. He decided to come back to the Staples Center to perform. Fatal mistake. Mike should have stayed over there until the concerts was done. He came back to L.A. They sent Conrad Wuerl, not Wuerl, the brother who murdered him. I forget his name, the black doctor. Conrad Murray. I think he did, what, 5 years? He's home. And he will be comfortable for the rest of his life for keeping his mouth shut.
Who is the face of the NFL right now to you?
It's Patrick Mahomes.
By far.
Yeah. See, here's the thing. Lamar Jackson.
Dude, Keyshawn makes a good point. I never thought about this. But check it out. Good point. This is a good little clip right here.
Should get the opportunities. But we live in a corporate world. And I don't necessarily know when they look at Lamar, if they look at him and say, he could be the face for a number of reasons. Okay, he's deep south. So they already, you know how they Florida. They,
how we talk, yeah, yeah.
That's how they are, because in 2019, he won the MVP.
Yeah.
Have you seen him on any commercial?
Nope. About to win it again this year.
And he going to win it again. That's the messed up part about it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But when you bring it to the attention, people get, they get all, they don't want to talk about that.
Right.
It's like, well, wait a minute, man, hold on. This dude, two-time MVP in 6 years. Meanwhile, the dude that we all keep hyping up, keep going home and Josh Allen, but y'all keep putting him on EA Sports and putting him on this and putting him on that, and he keep getting sent to the crib. So you look at it and you say, how could this be? This can't be this way this year with him. They've got to figure out, because they did it in basketball with Lil Penny, right?
Word.
Penny didn't like to talk, but Nike got so creative.
I love this. That's
that they figured
call.
Up.
That's,
huh?
That's a great call. I love that idea.
Yeah, think about it. They figured out, because when you think about Lil Penny, and obviously this is when we all first started playing and becoming professionals and making money and whatnot, we looked at that. They brought in Tyra Banks and Chris Rock. So they bought a beauty in, then they bought a funny man in, and Penny didn't really have to do a whole lot, which is okay. They need to figure that out with Lamar. Because they say Lamar doesn't have a personality, so to speak. Like, he's not outspoken type, you know, personality. Got a little Southern twang to him. That's okay, though. If you really want to make it work, I can make it work for you in a heartbeat. I promise you. I can put the shit together from a marketing standpoint.
If you really wanted to do it, though.
If you really wanted to do it.
If you really wanted to do it.
If you really wanted to do it, I can put him in all the little State Farm commercials and everything else. Yeah. If you really wanted to do it.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Because think about it. What MVPs in any league?
Not doing that.
Not doing commercials and stuff.
Not doing everything.
In any league. Some dudes ain't even in the MVP conversation to get commercials.
Still doing it, right.
Come on now.
Yeah, right.
But that's, you know, that those two dudes to me are the face of the league, you know, to me. But I could be wrong. They may tell me it's TJ Watt or something. I don't know. Those two dudes to me are.
What the hell?
That's interesting, because these conversations are starting to get mainstream, right? Like, we're talking about this, but, you know, these people got a voice. They got millions of listeners. And these are the type of conversations that are starting to, you know, people are starting to wake up to the BS, right? Back in when Keyshawn's still on, you know, ESPN and all that, but, you know, people are going to YouTube and doing podcasts. Like, they're on that, what is that, All the Smoke podcast with Barnes and Jackson. You know, you're allowed to talk about what you, look what we're talking about right here on YouTube. You're not allowed to talk about what you want. There's things that my videos have got cut off. My live stream got cut off. You know, stuff has happened where you talk too much about something, they'll cut you off, right? On my, you know, Google AdSense, there's something up top that we can't talk about, a certain war going on. Because you won't get paid if you do, right? So there's things you can't talk about on YouTube. But these conversations are these good conversations are starting to come up. Why isn't he the face of the NFL? You know, why is this guy? Why is this guy that constantly loses in the playoffs not the face of the NFL, right? Or is he's the face of the NFL when he's constantly losing, right? But I'm liking these conversations. People are starting to wake up. Celebrities, the real celebrities that aren't about that oath, right, are starting to you know, come out of the woodworks and start talking a little bit. I like it.
What's going on here, America?
I used to look out into the crowd, and I promise, I know you're going to think I'm lying to you. I used to look out and see faces change.
Well, wait.
Everything felt demonic.
Travis Scott.
Just drink it. So me and Pac still talking. Out of my fucking periphery, nigga. Look, I can't make this up, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? I can't tell anybody this kind of shit. So I'm giving this shit to you exclusive. Check this one out. So out of my periphery, you know, you see certain shit through your periphery. So I look, and it looked like something, like the bitch was moving, like, but it looked like something else, like some horror movie.
Okay, not to interrupt, but I just downloaded a clip today that's going to be in either Wednesday's or Friday's video. I forgot. But it's somebody talking about your peripherals. They're starting to come. He was saying eventually they're going to be, you know, in our, you know, hindsight, whatever. Not in our peripherals no more. But hearing him talk about seeing that, we see things in our peripherals, right? In my house, I see dogs. I see, you know, what I think is my dog. And I look and he's on the sleep on the couch. Or, you know, you see movement in your peripherals. And we got some clips coming up in this week's videos talking about these peripherals, but, you know, I had to interrupt them because it made me think of that.
Nigga, listen. It looked a little bugged out, so I looked again. Bitch was regular pretty. I turned my head. I see some shit moving. I was like, so I'm saying to myself, am I high? Well, me and this nigga been smoking some good shit. I looked again. The bitch face kind of like disfigured, nigga.
Damn.
Now, hey. All I know is when I saw that motherfucking movie, Devil's Advocate.
When people start going, hey, they're telling the truth, right? Because he's saying, like, I ain't trying to sound crazy or nothing. Like, I do it too on these videos sometimes. Like, I don't know. But, you know, that's like a body language of somebody, like, you know, when you do that, like, hey, I ain't saying it, but I'm saying it, right? You know what I mean? That's some body language type thing in your subconscious saying, like, this is what I saw. You don't got to believe me or not, but
I was like, I seen that shit. The bitch was like that. So, nigga, it was a scene in there like that. Nigga, I went Pac, nigga. I looked again, and the bitch face was regular. I looked again. Well, and it was like the bitch was switched back. It was like she was morphing. I looked again. I said, yo, Parker, get the fuck out of here. He was like, what's the matter, man? He said, we're going to bring the bitch. I said, we not bringing them bitches nowhere with us.
This video is fake and scripted for entertainment purposes only, for educational purposes only. It's fictional TikTok, but if you know, you know. Ooh wee.
I mean, do you feel that Hollywood is still racist?
No. Hell, motherfucker, yeah, they racist. Is you fucking crazy? Did you see the new movie about Moses?
Right.
How the fuck is the gladiator dude Moses? Get the fuck out of here. This is in Africa, not some small village in Sweden. Who comes up with this shit? That's like me playing JFK. Eddie Griffin as John F. Kennedy. The movie gonna start with my black ass getting shot, then the rest of the movie's about the white detective trying to figure out who did it.
What do you think, what do you think was some of the most racist things that you've dealt with being in Hollywood?
Hollywood, man. All right, you see the money they'll put behind an unknown white talent just starting out, right? When we all came out, this goes from Martin show to me and Malcolm show to Jamie Foxx show, so on and so forth. They put us on these new networks. Remember they had UPN, I used to call it You Pick a Nigga. The You Pick a Nigga network. Every black show creates this network. Once this motherfucker is built on our backs, they sell the motherfucker. Where's UPN at? Hey.
In Atlanta right now, you have something called Spelman
College. Checkmate.
You know who Spelman is, right? That's John D. Rockefeller's wife. Her last name is Spelman. Last name is Spelman.
That's the man's wife?
That's his wife.
Look at Spelman down south.
Man, Google it right now. Google who Spelman.
Go look this up.
Check this out.
Mrs. Laura Spelman Rockefeller.
Ooh! Let's not talk about Morehouse. Let's not talk about, look, all these medical colleges go, look, you think it goes back to somebody that's black? They don't. All these medical colleges go back to subsidiary and basically names or middle names or third grand. These are named after, all these different medical colleges is named after John D. Rockefeller family. and you can trace them back. Just like you can trace back all the presidents to come from one entity, come from one bloodline, you can do the same thing with every medical college. Now, within the last 20 years, there's a bunch of new medical colleges that came up outside of that, which still follow the curriculum, but don't have their name. But when you start studying these names, man, they go back to John D. Rockefeller family, man. They go back to his family names. He owned these schools. That's why if you go and you teach against them, you can get locked up and persecuted, because he sits at the head of the federal directors in the federal Supreme Court. John D. Rockefeller, man, he controlled the damn world, man. Him and the corner G's.
I'm snitching. I'm snitching in the kitchen. Diddy. Gotta tell on him. He tried it on me. So I know it's true. I was married, my ex-wife. I got a phone call in the middle of the night, about 2:30 in the morning. It was my wife says, pick up the phone. It was an unknown number. Pick up the phone. What bitch is calling? Who's calling? Picked up the phone. It was Diddy.
And he That's said, funny.
Hey, man, we didn't see what BET Awards. What you doing? I'm in bed with my wife. He said, I'm at the Beverly Hills Hilton, the Beverly Hills Hotel. I said, what's up? I said, who over there? He said, just me.
There's a saying, when the devil ignores you, then you know you're doing something wrong. Wait a minute, I'm not done now. You know, the devil goes, oh, no, leave him alone. Hey, he's my favorite.
Right.
Yeah. Conversely, when the devil comes at you, maybe it's because you're trying to do something right.
All right, family. There you have it. Damn good reaction. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys made it this far, be sure to hit that thumbs up. And if you're new here, hit that subscribe button. Y'all, we do about 4 uploads a week, and live streams are coming soon. I don't know when, but they're coming soon. So be on the lookout. I will let you guys know before I go live. But hey, this is Segovia. I'm signing out of the Man Cave. I'm going to see you guys on Wednesday. Later. Have a good day.